seasonal selective memory. Paul's point in saying to forget is to make sure that the pain of your past doesn't make you miscarry your pregnant possibilities of your future. Let me back it up and miss that one too. Paul's point is saying to you, don't let your pain of your past make you miscarry your pregnant possibilities of your future. In other words, don't let your hurt, don't let what folks have done to you keep you from moving on, because God's got something for you to do. So that's why every now and then you gotta come out into your tent, get out there for 7 days, as it were, and just begin to say, thank you. I look back over my life. Some of y'all can remember when you drove a Pinto, but now you're driving a Cadillac, you're driving a Lexus, you're driving a Malibu, you're driving what you want to drive, because God's opened up some doors for you. Some of y'all can remember when you had no air conditioner, you could just open up the windows and pray for a cool breeze. Then you got you a little window unit, but you went from a window unit to central air and heating. God's been good to you. Some of y'all can remember living in a project where you had to fight going out, had to fight coming in, had to have four locks on your door, had to worry about who may break in. But now you own your house, and you're going when you want to, lock the screen door, and say, God, you've been good to me. Every now and then, you got to remember to visit your son or your daughter, but now they're free, got a good job, working every day. Now you can say thank you. Then I stop there, but some of y'all can remember you wore an orange suit, you were behind the bars looking, but you're on. Second, I gotta go on. The feast.